to introduce you to the concept of composite materials. So what is a composite material? A composite material is a combination of two materials, and these two materials are combined at a macroscopic scale with chemically distinct phases. Remember, the constituent materials which are used to make up this particular composite material will have significantly different properties, but we can call only certain materials as composites. Why? What happens is, combine two or more materials, this particular combination should result in significant property changes, not slight property changes. That is one of the conditions. Then the next condition is, when the constituents percentage is generally more than 10%, then we can call it as a composite material. See here, generally composite material contains two types of phases. This is the fiber phase and this is the matrix phase. When we combine both the phases, we are going to get a composite material. So generally we can call this phase as reinforcement phase, this phase as the matrix phase. So we are going to combine both of the phases to get a composite material, and remember, this particular material will have significant properties in comparison with the individual materials, which is the reinforcement material and the matrix material. Then some of the examples of naturally occurring composites are wood. Say in wood, you can find cellulose fibers that are embedded inside lignin matrix. And then one of the occurring naturally occurring composite is the bone, where the stiff mineral fibers are present inside the soft organic matrix. And then granite is also an example of naturally occurring composite material. So then, coming to the examples of man-made composite materials, one of the most important material is known as the concrete, wherein we are going to have the limestone, sand, cement and water mixed together or combined together to form a product known as concrete. Then other one is the plywood, where several layers of wood are glued together to get the required properties. And fiberglass composites, all of these composites you are going to see in your everyday life. Then there are some materials like known as, say, plastics, alloys or metals with impurities. So why can't we call them composite materials? So what happens is, even though there are many fillers that are present inside plastics, they don't alter the physical properties of the plastic significantly, and again we cannot distinguish them chemically. Then in alloys also, the two or more materials are combined at a microscopic scale, where the bonds, atomic bonds, will be created between these two materials. But in composite material, what happens is, these two combined materials will remain distinguished from each other. Then metal with impurities is also the same case. So that is why we are not calling either plastics, alloys or metal with impurities as composite materials. We have created a new class of materials known as the composite materials. So then you need to know about some terms inside composite material before going further. So what are those terms? As I told you, the composite material contains of two phases. First one is the matrix phase, second one is the reinforcement phase. When we combine both the matrix phase as well as the fiber phase, we get a layer of a composite which is known as a lamina. When we take this lamina and we glue together different laminas or a number of laminas, we get another composite known as the laminate. And you see, you are going to stack one ply or one lamina on other, and the process of stacking one lamina on other is known as stacking sequence. Coming to the terms matrix, it is a homogeneous base which forms bulk of the composite material. The fibers which are embedded for reinforcing, and these particular fibers are responsible for the anisotropy of the composite. Then a lamina is nothing but a material in sheet form, usually referred as ply or layer. The material properties of the layer are determined by homogenization process, and once we prepare this lamina, from this lamina we can stack different layers of lamina to make a laminate. Then you have seen the matrix. There is a terms known as, there is a phase known as matrix phase, and there is another phase known as the reinforcement phase. So what is the function of the matrix phase? So the matrix phase main function is to bind the fibers together and then transfer the load that is applied on the composite to the fibers. So what happens is, if you are going to take a matrix and you are going to embed fibers, then the matrix is the phase which is responsible to transfer the loads to the fibers. So with this function, it is going to provide the rigidity and a shape to the structure or a composite part. Then it isolates the fibers so that individual fibers can act separately. So what happens if a lot of individual fibers are coming together, the fracture occurs and the composite is going to fail very soon. This particular matrix will be separating all these fibers, which stops or slows down the propagation of the crack. So it stops or it delays the failure of the composite. Then again, it also provides a good surface quality for preparing the composite parts. And then it provides protection for the fibers against the chemical as well as mechanical damage, that is nothing but wear. And then again, depending on the type of matrix and the fiber and the compatibility between the matrix and the fiber, the properties such as ductility, impact strength, etc. are also influenced by the matrix phase. Then coming to the functions of fibers, the main function of the fiber is to carry the load. So in a structural composite, if there is a 100% load applied, then the 70 to 90% of the load is carried by the fibers. These particular fibers are going to provide the required strength, stiffness, thermal stability, even electrical conductivity or insulation, depending on what type of fiber you are using. There are a lot of types of fibers you can use, and depending on the type of fiber you are using, you can get lot of different combinations of stiffness, strength, thermal stability, electrical conductivity and other things. Then we come to the classification of composites. Classification of composites can be broadly done in two ways. The first classification is which type of reinforcement is present inside the composite material. Next one is what type of matrix is being used to prepare the composite material. In the first phase, the composites are divided into generally four categories, where particle reinforced fibers, fiber reinforced composites, structural composites as well as nano composites. See here, the particle reinforced composites are again divided into two types, large particle and dispersion strengthened composites, and the fiber reinforced is again divided into continuous, discontinuous. In discontinuous also you are going to get two types, that is aligned or randomly oriented. And in the further slides we are going to see about the structural, which is again divided into laminates and sandwich panels. So in the future slides we are going to deal or talk about it. Then coming to the classification of composites based on the matrix material used, we can classify them broadly into four categories, which are polymer matrix composites and metal matrix composites and ceramic matrix composites and carbon matrix composites. In polymer matrix composites also we can divide it into two types. First one is the thermosets and the next one is the thermoplastics. Remember, these two belongs to the same polymer family. So what happens if the matrix phase is a polymer, then we can call it as a polymer matrix composite. If the matrix is a ceramic one, we can call it as ceramic matrix composite. If it is a metal one, we can call it as a metal matrix composite. This is how the classification of composites based on the matrix material is performed. See, there are different types of matrix materials like thermosets and thermoplastics. Both thermosets and thermoplastics belongs to polymer family, then metals and ceramics. See, the fiberglass materials, there are fiber materials, there are glass, carbon, aramid, boron and ceramics. This particular list is not actually, this is not only the list, we have several lot of matrices and fibers that are available in the market. These are only to show some of the examples and some of the highly used are highly applicable matrix as well as fiber materials in industry. Then coming to what is a particle reinforced composite. As you can see here, particles are used to reinforce the matrix phase. So as I told you, in composites there are two phases, matrix phase as well as the reinforcement phase. In the reinforcement phase, instead of fibers we are going to take particles, then we can call it as a particle reinforced composite. See here, in a ceramic, aluminum particles are embedded inside a ceramic matrix. See, the particles may have any shape or size, but generally we will have some spherical, ellipsoidal or irregular shaped particles that we are going to embed into the composites. Then coming to the next type of composites, that are the fiber reinforced composite. So what we'll do is we'll take a matrix and we are going to reinforce this matrix with the fibers. As I told you, there are two types of fiber reinforced composites. First one is the long fiber reinforced composite and the second one is the short fiber reinforced composite. See here, these two are the examples of short fiber reinforced composites. These two are the examples of the long fiber reinforced composite. Again, this can be divided based upon the alignment. See here, the short fibers are randomly oriented here in this particular matrix. Here they are aligned in a certain direction. Here also long fiber is randomly oriented in this particular lamina. Here they are aligned in one simple direction. Based upon this type of alignment also, we can divide these composites into whether randomly oriented composites or aligned composites. See, here is an example of a short fiber reinforced composite where the glass fiber is randomly oriented here, but this is an example where the glass fibers are continuously embedded inside the matrix. That this is an example of long aligned glass fiber composite. Then again, the fiber can be reinforced in several types of forms inside the matrix. The first form is what we have learnt, is unidirectional form. Then next one is the woven form, and the third one is the mat form. You can get knit form, stitched form and braided form. This all composites are mostly we will be using this unidirectional as well as the woven composites. Then based upon the structural classification, we can classify composites into two types. One is the laminates and another one is known as the sandwich panels. So what happens in a laminates? So in a laminates, we are going to take the laminas and we are going to stick one lamina with each other on the top of another lamina. So what happens is we are going to take a group of laminas and according to the required properties, we are going to stick them together to form a laminate. So then the next structural composite is known as a sandwich composite, where the honeycomb core will be placed between two face sheets. Here it is the face sheet, it is the honeycomb core, and attach both of these particular sheets or layers, an adhesive layer is present between the face sheet and the honeycomb. So what happens is this particular honeycomb structures or the sandwich panels are used for stiffening the lateral direction, especially in the fuselages of or fuel tanks of aircraft. See here, this is usually made up of either a metal or otherwise it is also made up of a composite laminate, and this is also can be made up of paper, balsa wood and other things. We are going to see in the further slides, we are going to see what are the materials that are used for producing this particular honeycomb structures. See, for the core materials, as I told you, this is the core material. We can use a number of types of core material in the sandwich structures. See, some cores are made up of foam like polyurethane, polyvinyl chloride as well as polystyrene foams, and some cores are made up of honeycomb structures. See, here is the honeycomb structure, and this particular honeycomb can be made up of either aluminium, some plastics, as I told you, paper, and then other thing is wooden cores, which can be made of balsa wood or pre-stressed wood cores. Then after that, we are going to see a gel coat. A gel coat is nothing but it is a specialized polyester. The main use of this particular gel coat is to give a good appearance on the surface of the product. Along with the high quality finish, it also increases the durability and resistance of the outer surface, and this is also one important thing we need to take into consideration while testing a composite material. Then in the next video, we are going to see what are different failure indicators and what are different applications of the composite. Thank you.